We now bring in former Mets catcher and current SNY analyst Anthony Recker. And since we're at the All-Star break, Anthony, let's reflect, okay? So what are your first half impressions of the Mets right now?
Look, this team has gone through a lot of adversity, right? They've had all these injuries. They've been working through it. You've had some up and down performances from certain players. The offense has really struggled at times. There have been a lot of key players out for the offense. Obviously, on the pitching staff and the starting side, deGrom has missed a little bit of time here and there. Stroman and Taijuan Walker have been great for this team. They've really been the rocks of that rotation, basically making almost all of their starts. The back end has had some problems, too, with injuries. And, of course, the bullpen, a little bit of that up and down as well. I'd say early on they were very good. As of lately, they've had some slip-ups, but I would say they've also had to cover a lot of innings and a lot of time based on some of the injuries that we've had from the starting rotation. So I think you have to take all that into account and take into account where they are in the standings in the NL East, number one in the division. And you have to take that and say they've done a great job with where they're at right now. Could they, maybe springboard into the second half and perform a little bit better? Absolutely. But based off what we've seen so far, they're in a very good spot. With everything else going on in that NL East, they have a very good shot at winning the division, so they're in a great place.
Yeah, you can always, want more, but when you're first at the All-Star break, you got to be happy about that. And we told you all earlier about Carlos Carrasco's rehab start. So what did the Mets learn about their staff with Carrasco out?
Well, with Carrasco out, they've had to really dig deep, right? They've brought up a guy like Tylor Megill and really found something, I think. I mean, that's a great surprise to find in a guy that they weren't really expecting to make any kind of a contribution this year. And he's really pitched. He hasn't gone deep into a game yet, but you give him the opportunity to keep coming in, keep pitching, keep learning. And I think he can give you that. And then, of course, you've learned that Jacob deGrom is the best pitcher in all of baseball. We already knew that, but he's just cemented it with the first half he's had. But Taijuan Walker and Marcus Stroman specifically have really been rocks in the middle of that rotation. And they've given you, and I think a lot of people thought with Carrasco, he'll be a great 2-3 and you could slide the others back. But even without him, even without Carrasco, they have really been so steady, so consistent, and given this team a lot of really good innings. When you talk about that, to me, that just means that this team is set up for a lot of success in the second half. If, of course, they can get Carrasco back, it'll be huge and it'll only help. But right now, they're not sitting too bad, so you got to love that.
You bring up Taijuan Walker. You brought up Marcus Stroman. Aside from deGrom, who you also brought up, who's been the biggest surprise for you at this first half?
Yeah, I was a big proponent of Taijuan Walker. I really liked him coming into this season. But what he has done has been nothing short of just extraordinary. Coming off the career that he's had, getting called up in 2013, parts of 2014, 2015 really kind of his first full season. Then, and never really fulfilled the potential, I think, that a lot of people put on him over in Seattle when he was over there. Ends up getting traded over to the Diamondbacks, gets hurt there. Tommy John, he's out for almost basically two seasons. And then coming back last year, pitched very well, especially in that second half of last season with the Toronto Blue Jays when he was over there. But coming into the offseason, nobody really expected much from him. I mean, that's why he didn't have a deal sitting on the table from anyone. And, of course, the Mets suffered some attrition early. They learned that Carrasco was going to be out, said, Taijuan, hey, we'll take you. Well, you know what? He turns out to be a fantastic find. And he has, like I said, been a rock in the middle of this rotation. All-star. This guy's an all-star. He got subbed in, but the heck with that. He should have been an all-star from the start. So very impressed by Taijuan Walker.
No, I'm totally with you. He absolutely deserved the all-star spot from the jump. All right, Anthony Recker, thanks so much.
Thanks, Chris. Appreciate it.